Hello everyone, this video is for class 9th and the subject is Information Technology. As you can see, the name of the first unit of Information Technology is Fundamentals of Computer. It consists of 9 sessions in sequence order. It is Introduction to Computers, Parts of Computer System, Computer Fundamentals, Types of Computer, Computer Operating System, Performing Basic File Operations, Communication Technology, Internet and World Wide Web, Communication Technology and Media Devices, Computer Security and Privacy. Now let's discuss Session 1, Introduction to Computers. This word computer is derived from compute, which means to calculate. Now, as we all know, a computer is an electronic device that can perform a variety of tasks by executing given set of instructions. That means we can give some instructions to the computer and it works according to our instructions. It processes that instructions given by us and give the output. As you can see, the full form of computer is common oriented machine, particularly used for trade and education research. Computer is nowadays used in every department and able to handle multiple tasks like documentation, accounting, designing, budgeting, entertaining, imparting, airlines, railways, and many more task it can perform. Now let's discuss the characteristics of a computer. It can having both its strength as well as limitations. Now let's discuss strength of the computer. First one is speed. As we all know, a computer work at an amazing speed without making any mistake. A normal person would complete a specific task in few hours, whereas the same task is finished by a computer within fraction of seconds. Now, the second one is accuracy. A computer performs its task with great accuracy. It cannot commit any mistakes in the processing of data. The errors generally occur when the input is inaccurate or the hardware is not functioning properly. Now, the third one is reliability. A computer is more reliable than a human being as it never gets tired and bored of the repetitive task. It can operate for long hours without taking rest with its accuracy intact. A computer can store a large amount of data in its memory, whereas a human being can retain only a limited amount of information. The data stored in the memory can be retrieved whenever it is required. Now the fifth one is versatility. A computer can perform various types of jobs, like we can play music while doing any work in MS Word. We can do calculations, we can play games, make animations of the internet, send email, and many more tasks we can perform at the same time. Now the sixth one is reduction in manpower. As we know, computer is able to perform all types of data, all types of tasks, so it reduces the needs of man means manpower in any organization. And the last one is reduction in paperwork. As we know, a computer stores data in the form of records that help in reducing a lot of paperwork. For example, the record of a student in a school can be stored on a computer rather than keeping the manual files for each individual. Now let's talk about limitations of computer. The first one is incapability of think. incapability to think. In this, a computer cannot think and take decisions on its own. That means, in case of any error, it cannot take an alternative action, as we can do. Now the second one is no intelligence. Unlike human beings, a computer has no IQ. That means it needs instructions at every step. And the last one is dependence on power. As a computer is an electronic machine, thus it is fully dependent on the power, which makes it costly.